Hello and welcome to the Slingshot Channel, New Year's Eve edition 2021. Okay, so for the second time in a row, Germans are not allowed to buy firecrackers and rockets and so on. Other than that, typically for 48 hours on the 31st of December and on the 1st of January, it is legal in Germany to make a lot of noise using firecrackers and so on. But because of the corona situation, to not make the situation in the hospitals worse, the government decided to ban the sale of the firecrackers this year. But that doesn't mean that we here at the Slingshot Channel will not make a loud, loud noise. But how can we make some noise that is as loud or louder than a firecracker? Well, there are things that are designed for this. So, let me show you what I came up with. What is this? Well, actually, this is a truck air horn. And a matching little compressor. Amazing that you can buy these two things for just about 32 euros on Amazon. It's supposed to have 150 dB, so this means it's really well over the pain threshold. And it is. I can tell you, it is so loud. So loud. I accidentally just discharged it in my workshop, and I was just having a ringing noise in my ear for the whole evening. So it is super, super painful. Because this is made for trucks to warn other trucks. So yes, it is super loud. Well, and then of course this needs power, typically 12 volts. Well, I wanted something that is rechargeable, so I've been using one of my Makita battery packs, but they have 18 volts. So I'm actually running this on 50% higher current, which will probably only make it louder. Probably not gonna last very long this way, but hey, I mean, we only have 48 hours anyway, so. Then also I had to make a switch, and I just wanted to have like a push button switch that automatically releases just like a trigger would. But the problem is that the one that I bought on Amazon only does 3 amperes, and this easily sucks out like 13 amperes of power. So it was melting away. So I've been using a very solid switch, and then I added the spring that actually makes it possible to automatically return. Oh, it is loud. Now, this will be a complicated video, just because it is very hard to demonstrate this, because the camera microphone will certainly clip the audio. I don't think it can record like 150 dB of noise. So it will clip, and then it doesn't really sound very loud when you watch it on your phone. What do I call this thing? Well, actually, I asked my loyal fans on Facebook, and I had a few suggestions. Let me read those to you, and you can name your favorite or make another suggestion in the comment pages. So the eardrum exploder, I kind of like that. And then this is for the Lord of the Rings fans, the Boromir Belitla. Then we have the earblood eruptor, and then the Lauden blaster. I like that too, it has a good ring, don't you think? Then we have the tinnitus triggerer. Then we have the no thanks expressor. It's like, you know, when someone knocks on your door and wants to sell you something, and you say, no thanks, dirt. Then we have, that's a good one, the deaf dealer. So not a death dealer, but the deaf dealer. Then someone suggests the cochlear collider. Well, it's really no collision, but I like the sound of that. Then we have, and actually a lot of people like that on Facebook, the final trumpet. But I also liked the Blastnikov 47. And the last one that is also good is the Tinnitus Maximus. So which one is your favorite? Leave a comment. I also like the steampunk look. See, it's the air coming from the compressor. And actually, the compressor is quite powerful. So if I take this off, this also doubles as the safety. You can really hear, and it's really getting a lot of air out here. So that's a powerful little compressor running at 18 volts, where it's supposed to only be run at 12 volts. So it clearly is loud. But is it louder or as loud as a firecracker? We'll find out, because I happen to have an audio level meter that's been in my workshop for years. So it's dirty but functional. So we will clock this from a distance of about 17 meters. simply because if you get closer than, you know, like 10 meters or so, it's going to max out, since it can only measure up to 130 dB. And this is louder than 130 dB. So we'll take some distance, and then we can simply use formulas and calculate the true level of audio. So this is my little audio level meter, and I can switch it on. And then you can see that it reacts, of course, when I talk. But I can also do a max hold. So I could go, ah! And that was 108. That's not bad. But of course, from like 17 meters distance, it's going to be a lot lower than this. So let's test it out. So this is the test device. You should be able to see it. And now I'm going to walk back and then shoot at it first, of course, with the new audio rifle. Okay, so I've been using an online calculator to figure out how much that is at point blank, so 10 centimeters distance from the muzzle. And it says 151 decibels. So between 150 and 151 decibels. So actually they said it's going to be 150 dB. And 150 dB is mighty. It's definitely in the pain range. I think it's about the noise of a gunshot, maybe even a shotgun shot. So it's really loud. But let's compare how the other stuff is behaving against it. For starters, we're going to use this little musical instrument that I bought cheaply on Amazon. I think it looks kind of cute. I wanted to use it with a compressor, but the thing is that if you just blow into it, no sound comes out. You have to like do funny things with your lips. Let me see if I can do it. Sounds a little bit like, you know, a castrated elephant. Anyway, let's see how loud it is.
That was good, wasn't it? My lips hurt.
That was actually not so bad, actually surprisingly loud. My calculator says that it was 132 dB at the point blank here. Amazing, and it is kind of loud. But I suck at it. Never mind. Well, you can also buy these on Amazon. These are actually made like for stadiums and football games and whatever. And actually, they are quite loud too, surprisingly loud. I was actually shocked because they're really loud. And kind of low. It's like vibrates in your stomach. Let's see how loud it is. This was actually really good. I mean, it did 102 dB here on the table. And this means that at point blank, it's 147 dB. That's almost as loud as my little trumpet. Although I think like from the feel, the trumpet is way louder, but I think that's normal. I mean, just 6 dB difference is like almost like twice as loud to the human ear. So there is a difference, but I'm still impressed how much noise you can make with this little thing here. So cool. So next, we're gonna use the firecrackers that I bought a few years ago, just because they were super cheap. And these are the loudest firecrackers that you can actually legally buy in Germany. It's the cubic firecrackers. And actually, you can hear, this is seriously filled with black powder. Actually, the black powder charge is about 4.6 grams, which is about 66 grain. Now, to give you a comparison, this is a Pedazzoli side-by-side shotgun, actually with the optional rear stock. And see, it's a Howda. I love it, but I can't fire it here because you can legally only fire it at a range. But just to give you a measure, so this is 66 grain, and you load each barrel with 25 grain of black powder for this mighty shotgun. So this actually has more than two, almost three times the charge of a single barrel of this here. So this is a serious firecracker and the loudest in Germany. Let's check it out.
It was loud.
Okay, not bad. I have to say, I'm impressed, because that was actually 99.39 at 17 meters. This means 144 dB at like point blank. But I managed to be louder than it with my trumpet of death. Louder than a firecracker. Good job, don't you think? So next we're gonna use a blank firing gun. Actually, this is a 9mm blank firing gun. This is still like legal in Germany. You can buy it without a permit. But for the Germans, that will change very soon. They want to regulate it. It's actually in the coalition papers, in the contract of the traffic light coalition. They've already decided that this will be regulated. If you want to fight so that these stay legal, I recommend going to the VDB website and registering and helping us to keep these things free. Now, these things are seriously loud, and it is legal to fire them today. So I will do that, and then we will find out if this is any louder than the firecracker. I hope that, because I can actually direct it towards the target, like so, right? That I will have a louder effect. But because a firecracker obviously distributes the sound in all directions. So we'll find out. This actually beat me, not by much, because as you can see from that distance, this means it's 152 dB, whereas we had 152, 151 dB with my trumpet. I'm a little disappointed, but still, I think it's good enough. Okay, now we're gonna see, interested? Now we wanna measure how loud Rolfi can bark. Rolfi is my sweet little puppy. He weighs 50 kilograms. And he's a mix of St. Bernard and Bernese Mountain Dog. And he can really bark, I can tell you. So we're gonna walk back, and then I'm gonna show you. Rolfi, hinten. Okay, that was 77. Now I'm actually louder than that, but that was 77.7 dB, which is really loud. Let's calculate how much that is at a muzzle point. This means he's doing 122 dB at muzzle point, like 10 centimeters, 4 inches away from his snout. That's a loud bark. So, how do you like my little tinnitus triggerer, or whatever it's called? You know, I think it's so loud and so sexy. And actually, it was really behaving well in the test field. And only the gun was a little bit louder, but not by much. And it was louder than the loudest firecracker that you could normally, in a normal year, legally buy in Germany. But anyway, what do you think of it? I love the steampunk look. And I really think that maybe by adding a strobo light, a really bright, you know, stroboscopic light, and maybe even a bayonet holder, I could turn this into a serious home defense weapon. Because believe me, if you try to steal like my stereo or my TV, and I fire with this thing at you, you want to take your hands and press them on your ears. And then, okay, the TV will be broken anyhow, but at least I will get a giggle out of it. And I just love the fact that I can simply take my Makita battery and put in a fresh one and then keep honking. I hope you like my little noisemaker, the final trumpet, the death maker, the instant tinnitus. I hope that you will have a great 2022. And I do hope that you eventually come back and watch some more of my videos. I'm really trying hard to keep you entertained. In any case, that's it for today, and I'll fire both winners at the same time to maximize the noise level. So, here it goes. Happy New Year!